Hello everyone, welcome to Hackeristan. And guys, today we will be talking about the walkthrough of Active Machine, which is a part of HackTheBox, the platform where this machine exists. So, which is a Windows operating system, actually which it is using. And the points for which this machine, if you crack, you will get 20 points. And this machine was released on 28th of July 2018, which has an IP address 10.10.10.100. I'm sorry in case if the image is little blurring, you may not be able to see clearly, but I have explained you the same detail to you guys. So guys, basically hack this box machine active is having the Kerberos and the Active Directory applications running on the Windows machine. What actually we will be trying to crack to get the user and the root flag sets by using the various the tools during this the challenge of cracking the entire active machine to find the right user and the root flag. So the tools that we will be using will be like SMB clients, SMB map, Active Directory, and the Kerberos ticketing, the process using the various tool like impact during the the hands-on demo. I'll be keep showing you the link also, and will keep walking you through about the details so that you can understand much better. So let's go ahead, guys. So before I move ahead, let me just tell you guys, already I have cracked the user and the root flag set, but for making this video, I'm again utilizing the same machine which has a IP address 10.10.10.100. So first of all, I need to just check whether my machine is pinging to me or not. So yes, it is. And then I will be start scanning to find the active port on this machine. So using this command, I will be simply enter. So I'll get the details, but to save a time, already I perform the same action. And here you can see that I have found already the ports which are open on this machine, like 53 DNS, 88 Kerberos, NetBIOS, LDAP, Microsoft DSSMB, the various other the ports which are open and can be utilized. Okay, so possibly the the machine, the operating system which is in use is a Windows Server 2008 R2SP1, and we have got some interesting details here. So the details are like here the SMB2 security mode, which it is showing the time of the domain controller in which the particular machine, the SMB2 is in running mode. And other than that, we have found some more interesting details, like over the LDAP, we can see that what is the domain details here, which we will be using during the, the machine cracking, time. So that time, same information will help us to crack the machine and the respective challenges we are in the process of cracking those. So let's move it, guys. So since I have found that the port number 445 is open, so let me just go ahead and start finding some more interesting information using this only. And the very first tool that I'm going to guys use is nothing but the SMB client. So basically guys, SMB client is nothing but the Samba client, which is working like a like interface, and it is a very helpful the tool that always helps us to have a test connectivity process in place to a Windows shares. So this particular tool also can be used for transferring the files or to look for the share names and the various the process and the enumeration can be done easily with the help of SMB client. So Kali Linux is already having this tool installed. There we go. All right, so now I'm going to type SMB space dash L is nothing but for listing the host to get a list of shares available on this host, and for which I will be using the IP address, and also along with that I'll be using dash N for nothing but for passing the no pass, which means that during the time it will be listing it down the shares information from the host, it will be enumerating those detail when no password is asked. So let's wait little guys here. So it has started. So anonymous logon because of this dash N got successfully executed, and resulting which we are able to find some shares name here. Basically doing this kind of enumeration of the shares is possible through various tools. So nowadays GitHub is available, is full of such tools which can easily help to find the details, and we can do the same thing the other way also. If you guys are interested, just click on browse computer, click on other location, and if I type smb :// 10.10.100 and as soon as I click on connect, so what it does, it will start connecting me with the shows directories here. So the same detail that which we are flashing on which we are able to see on the console CLI mode, the same is here. So the benefit is like either I'll go with this graphical click based, click based process to just check what the files exist in the other one. I can just follow up the console client CLI process also to enumerate bit faster. So here what we will do is, guys, the next thing that we are actually going to do is SMB client, and we are defining the host. And let's define the replication share name. So enter workgroup root's password. So again I'll enter and we'll see if anonymous password is, anonymous login is successful or not. So yes it is, and this is how we are getting the SMB login here, and we can start listing it down by typing the command dir. There we go. So the domain name is listed down here, and we can start accordingly enumerating the same details. So we can start just checking out some further details like cd active, hack the box, dir, and this is how we are trying to exporting the detail, but this takes some time. And so this is how we have to find the right file which is containing the password. And like I was saying, the pretty similar mechanism of enumerating the shares name that we are doing through SMB client can be also possibly done through the other softwares like enum4 Linux is the one tool there in the Linux machine already, Kali Linux machine already, just giving you this additional tool name so that you can use this in case if you want to enumerate the following details of the work group or a domain, NBT state details and the various other details about the share names. So this particular tool will automatically be fetching those details for you. So anyway, this is just an automated process in place, and the same I can do it through SMB map. Okay, so SMB map is also another one good tool that we have in Kali Linux, and basically this tool allows user to enumerate Samba shared drive, like Samba shared drives across the entire domain. It also helps us in listing it down the shared drives, drive permission, share contents, upload and download functionality, and file name, auto download pattern matching, and the various other things that we will be requiring to complete the challenge of finding the user and the root flag set. So since it is there already in the place in Kali Linux, I do not have to do anything. But so straight away, I'm just moving ahead onto the practical. So the intention of telling you about the SMB client and enum for Linux is that I wanted to update you that how it is so easy is to enumerate the shares name across the the entire domain, so which can be used for exporting the further details. But anyway, finally I'm gonna be moving ahead with the SMB map tool, and for using this tool, what I'll do is I'll be defining the SMB map dash R, and dash R is nothing but the recursively I need to define the list of directory from where I want to fetch some more directories. So in my case, hope you remember that I have found the directory name was replication, and then after that I have to define capital H, which is nothing but the host, defining process, so here also you can see that the dash H is nothing but the host name that you always define here. And in our case, the IP address is 10.10.10.100, and this is how I'm going to locate the right file that I'm looking for. Finding open SMB ports. Okay, so I'm re-executing the same command again. Now it has started. So you can see that it is finding the disk and the permission. So while this tool finds this detail, let me just take you graphically to the path and the directory that I'm actually looking for to get in. Replication connecting anonymously to login into the directory opening, so you have to wait little. There we go. So this may take some time, so please have some patience. active.htb. then I have to define this directory and the location. Now I'm going to policies. So some of you may be thinking why I'm so sure that directly I'm getting enter into this location. So the answer is here that we have already done the test, and the location of the file that we were looking for, so we have already located them. So in this video, while making this, I'm not actually, you know, like just going here and there and just, you know, like creating much topsy-turvy situation. So instead of this, I'm being on the same the track, and to just finding the details. That's it. Machines. So you can also keep a track of the directory we have finally got a chance to get in. Preferences. Group. And this is what the file we were looking for, actually, guys. So this file basically usually takes some time. So what we have attempted here is to locate this file and to copy this file, because the basically groups.xml is the only one file which is containing the user information, and which is, you know, like deployed there, or you can say just, you know, like copied there by the Active Directory actually application. So what we have to do is we have to just download this file. So either we can manually copy and paste, so it's easy, you know, that you have to copy and just paste to the, you know, like here somewhere. Sorry, hidden files was also open here, so I have hide them back. Okay, so either I can paste the file here, or what I can do is copy paste is easy, so you know about it very well. What I'll do is I'll just simply giving you the way that you can easily download the file. So to show you this demonstration, I'll be using a command dash a, and the file name that I want to download is this, and dash q. Now the question is, what does this mean of dash a and dash q? So very simple, smb map help. So dash q is already, you can easily understand that it is the command that always helps us to disabling the verbose output and only shows the sheer read and write detail on. And dash a we are using for defining the file name pattern, and will automatically be, you know, like matching that particular the pattern with the file name, and once it gets match will automatically download the file. So now I'm going back and entering the simply command this. So what will happen, this particular SMB map will, using this instruction dash a, to locate and to identify the pattern groups.xml, and will run it in the entire directory of replications and will search for this file. As soon as the string, you know, like this gets matched with the share under the replication directory, will automatically download this file locally for us, so that we can easily use of the same. So please have some patience, this may take some time, because as you can see that starting search for file matching groups.xml on share replication. So right now it's searching and identifying the pattern. So So you can see that match has been found, and now it is downloading the file now. So the file that we are downloading is actually having the password. So almost we are very close of it, at any point of time it will be, you know, like simply download the file. And yes, this is done. So just simply type ls, and this is the file. Simply copy and please type get to read the file and enter. So this is what the content that we were looking for. So we have got the name of the user here in this file. The username is active .stb, which is a domain, and then the svc underscore tgs is nothing but the user detail. And the password is this, which is having the AES encryption. So to decrypt this, what we will do is we have one software already in Kali Linux, which is nothing but GPP. This is a software that we have to look for actually. So GPP decrypt, yes. So since it is returning this command as uses GPP decrypt encrypt data, so now this means that the file actually exists here. Now what I have to do is we have to simply copy and paste . There we go. So finally guys, we have decrypted the user password, and this is how it's so simple is to find the password, and we have finally decrypted the encryption and got a details from there. So we are right now ready almost to just go ahead and find the first user flex set. But still we have to follow some mechanism here. So again I'm opening the new cmd prompt, so smb map as still the mechanism in the sense that just we have got the password, but we need to locate the directory and the file where that possibly this particular user .txt pass txt file exist. So now I'm going to show you how you can do the same as well. So smb map space dash d is nothing but to define the domain name. So the domain name is hacktive.htb, and then I have to use dash u for nothing but the username, and dash p for password. So username that we already know, svc underscore tgs dash p. So since we know the password now, I have to come back to old cmd console, the CLI console, space dash h for the IP address. So now what we are actually going to do is we are going to enumerate the disk, or you can say the share's name, with the permission when we log in to the user along with the password. So you can see that this is completely ulta. You can see that this is completely different what we have enumerated in the very first the method during the time of using the SMB map. So here it was showing you the details. But permissions were there. So the following are the directories which are having read-only access with this particular credential, and the following are the directories which we do not have access to, though we have a username and the password in place. So not a problem. We'll move ahead and we'll use this time user shares to use as a directory to list down that what all the files and directories exist in this. So we are just going to use the same. It just that we are using -r we are using recursively to list down the directories, and in our case I'm just using -r for users. So hope steps are very clear to you. So you can see that it has started listing us down the details of the files in the directory. Long list. So we have to wait little here, but once it is done it'll be more easy for us to identify the file that we are looking for. So these steps guys sometimes take time, but why I'm following up them and during this video why I did not keep them ready, because I wanted to just show you like result that I'm expecting to export from the commands that I'm executing without showing any shortcuts and keeping that the result ready, because it does not sync with what we are discussing and what we are right now trying to do with this command that we have executed. So anyway, it'll take another few seconds or maybe a minute. That's it. So we'll almost close to find the same the details. So you can see that it is searching every directory in the user folder or the user directory to locate that what all the files and the folder exist here. So now it has started using the different directory altogether. And listing down files and the directory. There we go. So this is the file guys that we were almost looking for. So now we are almost done. That's it. So now we have to just use the same command dash a for getting the pattern match with what we are passing through dash a command and space the file name dot txt dash space dash q for disabling the verbose output. So now what this will be command will doing is using this credential username and the password, it has logged into the to the domain and over this machine which IP is 10.10.10.100, and under the directory users it is trying to finding it out the user.txt file, and if the pattern matches on the shares user, so it will simply be downloaded on my screen. So this how we will be at least completing the very first practical. So again just wait a little more now guys here. Oh, so match is found finally under the directory users svc.tgs desktop user.txt and finally downloading the file. Okay. So we have successfully downloaded the file that we were looking for. Now simply type ls to check for the file, and this is what the file. Now we are almost ready to crack the first challenge, and there we go. So we have guys cracked the user.txt flex set finally, which is displaying on the screen. So this is how gives you the opportunity to read the file guys with the help of cat command, and let me just take a screenshot also. Okay, so we're done almost now. So what we have to do is guys, we have to move on next. So guys, now the challenge is next is for us to find the root flex set, and for finding the root flex set guys, we have to perform the Kerberos Kerberoasting basically attack, it is called. So which is related to Kerberos. So since the Kerberos service is open and running in our the active machine that we are cracking into its challenges, So basically guys, Kerberoasting is a particular attacking method that actually give the the opportunity to the attacker to easily cracking the password of the service accounts which are running in the Active Directory offline. So to do this, we will be using basically using the particular the software, and the software name is mpacket github. So basically guys, mpacket is a collection of Python classes which we will be helping to work with the various networking protocols during our test. So following the protocols that it are featured and supports to. So what we have to do is we have to simply type git clone. lscd mpacket enter. Now what we have to do is we have to use this command pip install space dash dot. So all the mpacket based softwares exist in this directory will automatically be installed in the root directory so that I can use them directly by typing the name. So the very first the file that I'm gonna use is get ad users, as its name is suggesting. It is going to help me to enumerate all the users from the domain and the respective the username from the the target machine and its IP address. So what we are actually going to do is we are going to use get ad user dash all, return all user, include those with no email addresses and disable accounts. When used with dash user, it will return users information even if the account is disabled. So that is the specific the execution of this command I wanted to perform to enumerate the such details, defining the domain, and we have to follow up this process. And active.stb slash username is svctgs space. I'm not defining the password. And the IP address. So let me get the details. Oh, it's asking me password. So enter. Okay, so following are the names of the accounts that I could fetch from the domain, from the Active Directory: administrator guest krb tgt svc underscore tgs. Tgs basically is nothing but having a full form ticket granting service. So anyway, this is what we have done. So now guys, this is a time to perform the Kerberoasting attack, basically like about which I was talking about. So basically Kerberoasting is a method that an attacker always use to steal the service account credential. So basically it's a part of the service ticketing, which is encrypted with the NT hash of the user. So any domain account can request Kerberos service tickets. So using the existing detail, I will be requesting for a ticket, and then post that once the ticket, request I will be raising. So once the ticket is raised successfully, I can use the same to crack the password offline using some tools that I have got it already. So anyway, what I'll do is I'll show you the method here, and what I'll do is I'll be simply just using the command, nothing but get user and get user SPN. SPN basically is nothing but the service principal names, so which will be helping me to perform the Kerberoasting attack, and that will help me to request for a ticket through the TGS service, ticket granting service. So for doing this, what I'll do is I'll be using a command DCIP, and that is nothing but 10.10.100, and this is the method that we have to use. So active STB SVC TGS colon, and the password that I'll be using to create a ticket, and will make a request for enter. So this particular command will help me. So guys, this is what the command has helped me to create a ticket. But one more update guys here, sometime there may be a chance that you are getting some error here, and the error is like Kerberos session error KRB AP FU clock SQ to great. So sometime you may face some error, which means that when you will be using this command, so as soon as you run this, you will see definitely this information, but instead of this ticketing detail, what you may observe is that some kind of error has come back to you. So in such cases, what does this mean basically guys? That basically the mean of such the error is that we need to work out what is the time of the domain controller is currently running on. So we have to accordingly just set the time of our local machine to fix this issue basically. So there is a two method that you can follow up. So I'm intentionally telling the same detail in this video only, so that those who of you are getting the same error doing this requesting time for performing the Kerberoasting attack, so you can fix the issue then and there and can get the exact detail that you are always expecting it to give you back. So now what you can do is guys, in case if you face the same, we have done googling on this a lot, and finally we got some information about some NTP server. So what we have to do is, first of all, we have to I'm directly showing this demonstration, that in case the first method is you can do this by running this command nmap dash p445 script smb2 time and the IP address. So this will be telling us the exact time of the domain controller currently is running on. So this is the time so that we can set timing, what we can do is we have some method in place like date. So you can see that the time exactly right now is happening. So what I'll do is for setting up the date and time, I can use this method set equal to, like, I can define the time as, for example, 2020 is a year, then month and the time, sorry, and the date, and space the timing that I want to feed here. So I can have the 5 minute gap so that I can accordingly increase the final time. Like, for example, I'll make it 52, enter. So when I'll type date, you can see that the time will automatically be changing here. So as many as time after that I can attempt, and then issue will fix. So this is how I can fix the issue and can start getting the ticket request detail. In case if still it does not work and help you, then you can go ahead and use the following method to bring the timing in line as per the domain controller timing, which your domain controller machine has got it running in the Windows operating system. So what you can do is then later point of time, just to show you separately, I'm opening the new terminal and then simply type system ctl stop ntp. So the network time protocol that what our machine was actually syncing up with will automatically be stop to sync up anymore. Now after that, ntp date enter, sorry, my bad, ntp date, and this is showing does not found actually, which means command does not found. So which means possibly this software itself does not have existence in the machine. So what I'll do is apt get install ntp date. So this is the method that I'm telling you in the future to use it in case to fix the issue. Now simply type ntp date and this is what it will be trying to fetch the detail from the domain controller running on this machine. So that you can see that this is the timing currently which is going on. And to sync up our machine back, what I'll do is I'll be using simply the command systemctl start space ntp. So automatically it will be sync up with the new the command. You can see that the exact the timing 3 basically we counted as for the 24 time format is considered as like a 15. So this is exactly time what we have matched up to now. So now guys, what we will be doing is after that also we can again just test and this is going to give you the ticketing details here. So this is how, guys, basically you can fix this issue in case if you face it. Now the question is what we have to do with this ticketing details. So what we have to do is we have to copy and simply type echo single quote, paste single quote greater than, and let me just give it some name to it like hash.txt. So now ls, so I can see that one file name has.txt is there on my screen. Now guys, what we will do is, now this is a time you know, like has reached for us to crack it. So to cracking it, I have two methods that I'll show you. The first that I'm going to show you is a Johntheripper. So Johntheripper, where I'll be using this basically you know, like the password file. And before breaking the password, I need to unzip the file, the password file with which I'll be trying to break the same. User share word list and rocku.txt.zz. So to extract the password file from it, we'll use gunzip format usr share word list rocku.txt.gz, and you will see that the file got extracted successfully. Now what we have to do is we have to type zone John, and to crack the password we'll use this machine, sorry, use the software. And now what we have to do is we have to define the word list. has.txt, and then after that we have to define the word list dash dash word list equal to usr share list q.txt. So we have started the Johntheripper tool, which will help us to crack the particular Kerberos ticket which has encryption, and we'll hit it to the word list that we have defined, and we'll check for the password, and the password is ticket master 1968. So anyway, this is the way that you can easily break it. Or else what you can do is you can also just use a method of cracking the same through a different software, and the software name is basically nothing but hashcat. Then after that hashcat dash m is nothing but the mode. And for the Kerberos ticketing, let's see which one will be the right one. So the hash mode that we are actually going to use, So network protocol Kerberos 5 that we are looking for. So this is the one that we'll be using, 313.100-A. And let's see what is the mean of dash A. Is nothing but the attacking mode. And let's see what is 0. Is nothing but the MD5. And then hash file name like hash.txt. And then after that, what we are defining is the word list. And dash dash force. So this is the simple command that we are actually going to use to break the password from the captured Kerberos ticket. So we have to wait little as it is checking. A lot of password, you can see the details here. So we have to wait a little here. Okay, so the status is cracked and the password is again ticket master 1968. So this is how we are confirming the password is 100% matching. So this is what the way, guys, that through which we can easily crack the password. So since we have cracked the password, guys, now we have to log in using the new tool name is a PSEXEC to the domain controller as a anti-authority system user-based privileges that we will be using during this tool use. So now what we are actually going to do is we are moving ahead and we'll be using the next tool, PSEXE. Now so now before I go ahead, let me just give you a small information about a PSEXE tool, guys. So basically PSEXE EXE tool is a basically command line tool that always helps to the pen tester to execute the processes on the remote system and redirect console application to the application output to the local system. So those applications which are running on the remote system can be appear to the system locally to which the PSEXE the software used by the pen tester. So basically, guys, now the PSEXE c.py tool is going to help me to allow me to log in to the target machine. So for doing this, what I have to do is I have to simply use the tool name is the PSEXE.py and the username like administrator. Hope you remember that we have enumerated the details of the user accounts which has a admin privileges. So the administrator is one of them, and then I'll be simply using nothing but the command prompt once I'm login through the PSEXE Y tool. So the method of login into it is this. All right, domain slash username, comma password at the rate target name or the IP address. All right, so now what I'll do is I'll be simply using psexe c, and then I have to use active dot stb vc tgs I'm sorry for the sorry this got typed by mistake. Active dot hack the box svc tgs sorry this is the time when we will be using the username to which we want to log in as is administrator colon at the rate 10.10.10.100. So let's see, and it is uploading some files on the remote server and going to help us to get us the shell, and there we go. So guys, let's check it out. Who am I? I am actually having the privileges of anti-authority system. So now let me just check it out dir. So sorry, so this is going to take a lot of time, so I have to run this command again because I have run this dir command under the C drive Windows system 32, so obviously it'll take a lot of time. So I've terminated the earlier session and just logging you know, like into the console again. So now I'll come back to the C drive first of all. Now I'll check C drive dir cd users dir. CD administrator dir. Let me attempt on desktop. Dir. There we go. So we have finally, guys, got it. A root flag. So to read this, I'll be using more space root.txt, and this is how I can easily, you know, like find the root flag set as well. So this was a small demonstration, guys, that I wanted to just show you that how you know, like we as a you know, like pen tester who is more interested to come in this field or already doing well and wants to improve their knowledge. So guys, the reason of starting this small you know, like platform Hackeristan for all of us, including me as well, guys, to discuss on such topics and to share the knowledge so that we all can exchange the information to improve our knowledge database. If we know something, we can share, and we can also just keep contributing, guys. If you think you have some more informative content to share with all of us, you are, you know, like completely having a freedom to join you know, like the Hackeristan, and you know, like to again share the your content, your preparation, your paper, or some, you know, like information that you think that you have some more informatic ideas with the new tool information, which could you know, like make all the people's in, you know, like knowledge much more improved, and you know, like will help to perform the pen testing in better way to efficient their, you know, like pen testing skills as well. So this was a small you know, like guys, the last moment introduction about the Hackeristan. As anyway, this is what I'm always keep giving. So thank you so much guys for watching this video and for giving your valuable time right from the beginning till the end of this video. So if you like this video, please like the video, please subscribe the video, please comment the video, so that we can understand better that what you liked, what you don't like, or what is a tool we could have been used if you were making the same video. So if you have any query also, you please reach out to us in case if no. So thank you so much, we'll see you in the next video. Till then, bye bye, take care, stay safe, thank you.